Hi, I'm Terry Molloy, also known as Davros, creator of the Daleks and nemesis of the Doctor. It's lovely. I mean, there's enough space to be able to spend time talking to people, which I love, because they all got sorts of stories about how they got into Doctor Who and who their favourite Doctors are and everything. And it's nice to be able to share that because you feel you're part of a big extended family, you know. And it's been lovely atmosphere. I landed the part by chance, really. In fact, Michael Wisher was meant to be playing it, but there was a BBC strike, so the production was moved sideways, which lost the director and Michael Wisher doing other things. And a new director was brought in who I just finished working with, and he knew my work and offered the part to me. So it was as simple or as complicated as that. It was great. I mean, great fun to be in that sort of thing. And obviously, they had to make a head mould of me in order to make a new mask. And that was quite a trial, you know, sitting there having your head covered in plaster of Paris while they take a head mould in which to do the mask from. And then getting into the studio and getting into the mask and the chariot and all the restrictions that imposes on you as an actor, you have to work through. But having done a majority of my work on audio, on radio, I'm used to producing characters with my voice and being restricted in physical movement. That was perfect for Davros. Well, obviously, I looked at Michael Wisher's performance and listened to how he had created the character vocally and started to replicate that. But then you do have to think about the character. And it's really, I suppose, it was several years later that I really got into understanding fully where the character had come from when we started doing some of the big finished stories. In fact, I, Davros, which was a four-part series which started from Davros as a 15-year-old when he was a perfectly normal, you know, beautiful-looking youth up to the point where he creates the first Dalek. So you see that transition from man to monster. How did it happen psychologically, physically? And that, for me, was a fascinating part of the whole job that I've been doing over the years. The Daleks, I mean, it's bizarre. It's one of those things that just happened. The Daleks, these sort of, you know, metal pepper pots have become these sort of horrible creatures. I suppose it's the fear of what's inside. People don't really know what's inside, even though we've seen glimpses. Davros, it's different because he's not a Dalek. And he has got a brilliant savant mind. And I think both he and the Doctor recognise they're on exactly the same intellectual plane. And probably they're the only people who are on that same plane together. And it's an intellectual chess game between the two of them. Plus, they both know they're both alone. And there's that kind of synergy between them, so that although they're trying to destroy each other, they're also almost trying to hold on to each other because they know if they get rid of the other, they are going to be alone in a very particular way. I mean, the Doctor is the Doctor is the Doctor, and I've loved them all over the years. I mean, I did actually, I was 16 when this programme started, so it tends to be the Doctor you grew up with. So, I mean, for me it was Hartnell and Troughton that set the seal, but all of the Doctors, you know, bring something of themselves to the other, but still retain that essence of being the Doctor. I mean, obviously, I work with Peter, and I work with Colin, I work with Sylvester. And now I'm delighting in watching when Eccleston came back. I just loved it. You know, he brought a new energy to it back in. I loved the film with Paul McGann. Sadly, it didn't. I mean, Paul McGann should have carried on, you know, being a Doctor. There's so much that both he and Colin, you now see, has been missed by them not being in it long enough on the television circuit. And now, of course, we've got Capaldi, who is just sort of, you know, just he's bringing all the elements of all the Doctors back into the part and bringing it back to that darkness that the Doctor has and does very, very well. That's not to say I didn't like David Tennant and Matt Smith. I loved them and a lot of the stories that they did. But I can't say I've got a favourite in terms of presenting the Doctor as the Doctor. I think it's the one that I'm watching at the moment, which is Capaldi, because that's going to be the one that is your favourite at any given moment in time, the one that's on now. Welcome. I am looking for new genetic material.
in order to become Daleks, so that the Doctor can be finally exterminated.